In this figure, let's examine how Leydig and Sertoli cells both promote spermatogenesis, and they function together to do so. Now, we'll start with a little bit of orientation here. We've got a seminiferous tubule in the upper left here, and they are formed by spermatogonium on the outside. They're going to divide and differentiate to lead to the production of sperm here in the lumen of this seminiferous tubule. But we also have this very important cell known as the Sertoli cell in green here that forms a blood testis barrier across which the developing spermatocytes must pass to enter the lumen of this tube. On the outside, we have the Leydig cells. And so we're going to blow up the Leydig cell here to see its function. And we're going to blow up that Sertoli cell, the green cell, over here to show its actions. And so we've got this sort of incomplete wall of the seminiferous tubule blown up in our major figure here. Now, we want to look at how our spermatogodium, we can add one here that would be, again, found outside the blood testis barrier formed by these Sertoli cells here. And those cells are going to divide and differentiate, and they're going to pass across this blood testis barrier. And to do so, they have to sort of zip and unzip these tight junctions found between the Sertoli cells, a very unique process. The Sertoli cells acting as those nurse cells aiding the development of these spermatocytes. And so many phases of mitosis are going to occur, generating lots and lots of spermatocytes. They actually have cytoplasmic connections until very late in their development, helping to coordinate the cohort of spermatogenesis occurring here. And then eventually their products are going to be released into the lumen of this seminiferous tubule. And of course, controlling this this passage across the blood testis barrier requires coordination and some of the hormones we're going to talk about here. Now let's talk about the regulation of this process. And to do so, we need to focus on the hypothalamus first. Its release of gonadotropin-releasing hormone into a portal capillary system that delivers it to the anterior pituitary. Saw that in a previous figure. The anterior pituitary, in response, will release LH from one cell type and FSH from another cell type, and that will lead to the activity of the Leydig cells and the Sertoli cells, LH being specific on these Leydig cells. It stimulates a pacemaker enzyme that leads to the production of testosterone, down here. Now, testosterone is going to be absolutely essential to spermatogenesis. Low levels of testosterone result in sterility. Now, we also can see that our Leydig cell expresses an enzyme indicated by this arrow known as aromatase, and that leads to the production of estrogen. Estrogen, even though that's known as a female hormone, is absolutely essential to spermatogenesis as well. So males are testosterone dominant. It's the higher concentrations found in the bloodstream, but very dependent upon estrogen as well. Now, let's follow that FSH for a moment. It's going to act on the Sertoli cells, binds its receptor here. We get the production of a second messenger, and we're going to activate transcription and translation of an androgen-binding protein. And we need this because we need high testosterone levels in these Sertoli cells and in the seminiferous tubule itself. And again, because that's important for spermatogenesis. But testosterone is lipophilic. It's derived from cholesterol. So it's rapidly taken up into a dense capillary bed and could be carried away. And some of it is. But we need to trap a significant fraction here. And we do that by making it not lipophilic, by binding to this protein, this androgen binding protein that traps it in the Sertoli cells. We get testosterone enhanced actions. We're going to secrete it into the seminiferous tubule over here as well. That's going to help promote our spermatogenesis. And we're going to overall be delivering that testosterone that's produced by the Leydig cells. We're trapping it and helping promote spermatogenesis and the production of our viable sperm, which are going to be released off into the subsequent tubules along the male reproductive tract.